minister orders minimizing inbound flights until dead over new coronavirus variant concerns. Vietnamese aviation ready to assist Indonesia after plane crash. Forces ready to ensure safety for the 13th National Party Congress. New York Times listed Côn Đảo among lovable destinations for 2021. Hello and welcome to FBC News with the latest updates from Vietnam. Now, Prime Minister Nguyễn Xuân Phúc has decided to minimize the number of flights carrying Vietnamese citizens back home from now until the Lunar New Year holiday, which falls in mid-February, as more contagious variants of coronavirus have been detected in many countries.
In a government office dispatch communicating the decision from the Prime Minister, the country will only allow in truly necessary flights that have been approved on a case-by-case basis by five ministries, including the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Ministry of Public Security, Ministry of Transport, Ministry of Defense, along with approval from the Prime Minister himself. Vietnam closed its border in March last year to curb the spread of the pandemic, but has gradually opened up to a limited number of flights which carry repatriated Vietnamese citizens from overseas, foreign business executives and experts from skilled workers and diplomats. The Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Health are tasked with preparing facilities to implement mandatory quarantine for all Vietnamese entrants. Quarantine length and protocol must be reviewed to take into account the increased transmissibility of the new variants of the virus. Local governments are asked to beef up inspections of quarantine facilities under their jurisdictions, except concentrated quarantine facilities managed by the military, to ensure the observance of COVID-19 prevention and control regulations. All short-term foreign entries will be placed under concentrated quarantine for 14 days, except in special cases considered by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. People who wish to return to Vietnam via land rounds but suffer financial difficulties will be considered for quarantine fee support by local authorities, according to the dispatch. After the Tết holiday ends, the Ministry of Transport should study the resumption of regular commercial flights as per the government's instructions to serve the dual goal of pandemic containment and economic recovery, as well as the travel needs of citizens.
Vietnamese Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs Phạm Bình Minh on January 10th sent a message of condolences to Indonesian Minister of Foreign Affairs Retno Marsudi over a recent Indonesian plane crash off the coast of Jakarta. The Sriwijaya Air flight, coded SJ182, crashed into the sea on January 9th, just minutes after taking off from Indonesia's capital Jakarta. The Boeing 737-500 plane with 62 people on board was en route to Pontianak in West Kalimantan. The Civil Aviation Authority of Vietnam, CAAV, stands ready to support its Indonesian counterpart with regard to the recent plane crash. In a letter sent to the Indonesian Civil Aviation Authority on January 11th, head of the CAAV, Din Vithang, expressed his deepest sympathy to the bereaved and hoped that the Indonesian agency will soon determine the cause of the accident. Relevant forces have embarked on the task of ensuring security and safety for the upcoming 13th National Party Congress, which is scheduled to open on January 25. The Ministry of Public Security, in coordination with the other ministries and agencies and the Hanoi People's Committee, held a ceremony on January 10th to launch the task of and conduct a drill ahead of the big event. More than 6,000 officers and soldiers of the public security and army forces and health workers of the capital city, along with representatives from 10 adjacent localities, joined the ceremony. Minister of Public Security General Tô Lâm blessed that the public security force will raise a high sense of responsibility and join hands with other units to drastically, synchronously and effectively roll out plans. The drill featured different hypothetical scenarios on security and safety, including fighting terrorists and rescuing hostages. You're watching FBC News. Dung An High Tech Agriculture John Stock Company will export 1,600 tons of high-value fragrant rice to Singapore and Malaysia, the Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development announced on January 13th. Accordingly, 450 tons of Jasmine 85 rice will be shipped to Singaporean market at $680 per ton, while 1,150 tons of Hung Lai fragrant rice will be delivered to customers in Malaysia at $750 per ton. These are very high prices for these products.
General Director of Dung An John Stock Company Phạm Thái Bình said the company is also preparing to export over 2,000 tons of rice to Germany. Bình said despite difficulties from the COVID-19 pandemic, Vietnam's rice industry has made breakthroughs in 2020, especially in value. Rice export value increased by over 9% in the year, although the volume did not rise as compared to 2019. In the early days of 2021, a number of member companies of the Vietnam Food Association, VFA, including Dung An John Stock Company, have signed many export contracts, especially with European partners and those from member countries of the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, RCEP, that Vietnam signed in November last year. According to MARD, Malaysia and Singapore are two among the 10 largest importers of Vietnamese rice. This is also a significant event after Vietnam had just signed the RCEP, together with other 9 ASEAN member states and 5 countries that the group had signed free trade agreements with.
The southern province of Đồng Nai secured 11 foreign direct investment projects worth more than $226 million in the first half of January, the highest recorded in the same time in the past 5 years, according to the Provincial Management Board of Industrial Parks.
Thanks to the investors' confidence in the Vietnamese economy, as well as the sound business climate in Đồng Nai, the province has attracted a huge amount of investment right at the outset of the year. Large projects included Hanson Electronics in Ho Nai Industrial Park and Ojitex Plant in Lộc An Bình Sơn Industrial Park. According to Chairman of the Provincial People's Committee Cao Tiến Dũng, since Đồng Nai has seen industrial development and FDI attraction as a top priority in 2021, despite challenges caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, the province will work to enhance investment promotion, complete infrastructure system to welcome new investment waves, and step up administrative reforms. Đồng Nai province now has 32 operating industrial parks, with an occupancy rate reaching over 80%. The province will open 3 other industrial parks on an area of 6,500 hectares in Long Thanh and Cẩm Mỹ districts, build Long Thanh International Airport, and construct various expressways such as Bến Lức Long Thanh, Dầu Dây Phan Thiết, Dầu Dây Liên Khương, and Biên Hòa Vũng Tàu.
The U.S. newspaper New York Times included Vietnam's Côn Đảo Island among its 52 places to love in 2021. The destinations were selected from more than 2,000 suggestions the paper received after asking its readers about spots that have delighted, inspired, and comforted them in a dark year. It said these places remind us that the world still awaits. Located around 230 kilometers southeast of Ho Chi Minh City, Côn Đảo Island was once dubbed Hell on Earth, home to a brutal prison where the French and American invaders jailed and tortured many Vietnamese freedom fighters during the 19th and 20th centuries. This is not the first time Vietnam's prison island has been highlighted by prestigious publications. In 2017, CNN praised it as one of 12 paradise islands in Asia, while US magazine Time included Côn Đảo in a list of 13 places around the world to amaze travelers with its blue water. Animal protection organization Humane Society International, HIS, has launched an emotional commercial for air travelers of Vietnam Airlines in the hope of reducing demand for rhino horn in Vietnam, which will help to ultimately end the poaching of rhinos in Africa.
The short ad titled When I Grow Up will play on passenger screens on all Vietnam Airlines flights as well as in premium airline lounges across the country. It features Vietnamese primary school children sharing their big dreams for the future. A little boy at the end of the story awakens the compassion and national pride of Vietnamese adults by urging them to stop using rhino horn. Dr. Teresa Telecki, Vice President of HSI Wildlife, added, "The increased demand for wildlife products in Vietnam and other Asian countries is one of many key threats to endangered species over the world. She hoped the message can touch emotions and gradually change behavior." When I Grow Up is funded by the Glenn and Bobby Seeley Foundation and is part of HSI's long-term efforts to reduce the consumption of rhino horn and other wildlife products in Vietnam and other countries. Rhino horn is valued in Asian countries for medicinal benefits, even though there is no scientific evidence to back these claims. Horns can be sold for high prices on the black market. HSI works around the globe to promote the human-animal bond, rescue and protect dogs and cats, improve farm animal welfare, protect wildlife, promote animal-free testing and research, respond to natural disasters, and confront cruelty to animals in all of its forms. The organization started working in Vietnam from August 2013.
The Japan Foundation Center for Cultural Exchange in Vietnam has launched the exhibition Traditional Japanese Dolls at the Ho Chi Minh City Fine Arts Museum. This exhibition features 32 traditional dolls depicting the gracefulness of Japanese women in kimonos, popular characters in Japanese no and kabuki plays, babies, children, and royalty. Japanese dolls are divided into different types according to the maker's skills and materials and themes and shapes. For the Japanese, the doll is not merely a decoration, but also a confidant representing the feelings of its owner. The exhibition provides Vietnamese audiences a glimpse into a part of traditional Japanese culture as well as the spiritual culture of Japanese people. The exhibition is open until January 27th. The museum is at 97A Phó Đức Chính Street in District 1. Entrance to the museum is $1.3. Now that has come to an end of FBNC News program this week. Thank you for joining us. We look forward to seeing you next time. Goodbye.